Good morning. Today's is the third class for module 3. We are going to start with measuring error. Now, we've seen what is true positive, what is false negative, true negative and false positive in the first module or in the second module. In one of the previous modules, we have seen what is true positive, false positive, true negative and false negative. Okay, let's just go through all of those things once again. Now, before I go into the definitions, I'm going to give you just a brief discussion of what we saw earlier. Now, what is a true positive? If a particular training data set or a testing data set, which is actually positive, has also been predicted as positive by the learning model or classification model, then it is a true positive. What is actually true has also been classified as true. Then it is a true positive. If what is actually true has been classified as not true, so the classification is negative, but it is actually positive. What is actually true has been classified as negative. That means we have a false negative. The classification is negative, but it is false. So what is actually true, if it has been classified as false, then we have a false negative. Okay. Now, what is a true negative? What is actually negative is also classified as negative. Then in that case, we have a true negative. Okay. Now, supposing the classification is given as positive, that means the learning algorithm has classified a particular data as positive and it is actually negative. So what has happened? It has been classified as positive, but it is not. So it is a false positive. Okay. So this is what we're going to see in the definitions. Logically, if you just think of that term, true positive means truly it is positive. The actual also is positive. The classification is also positive. True, negative. Actual is also negative. Classification is also negative. False, positive. Classification is positive, but it is actually negative. False, negative. Classification is negative, but it is actually positive. That is what is being seen in true positive, false positive, true negative and false negative. Okay, now the definitions. Consider a binary classification model derived from a two-class data set. So the classification is just two. It is either a yes or a no, a true or a false. Okay, so in that case, let the class labels be, that means the actual class label be C and not C. And let X be a test instance. So one particular instance or example we are taking. Okay. Now, what is a true positive? That the true class label of X be C. If the model predicts the class label of X as C, that means the prediction and the class is C. So it is true positive. False negative, let the true class label be C. So it is actually positive, but the model is predicting the class label as not C. So something that is actually positive has been classified as negative. So it's a false negative. Okay. True negative. Let the true class label be not C. If the model also is classifying it as not C, so it's correct. It is truly negative. Okay. False positive. The actual class label is negative, but the model is predicting the class label as positive. Okay. So actual class label is not C, but the model is predicting it as C. So we have a false positive. I hope only this part is clear. The rest of our performance measures for a classification algorithm will be clear. So I hope this is really clear for you. Now, this is called a confusion matrix. Okay. So we create a table in which the rows are the predicted label of X is positive and the predicted label of X is negative. So it's either positive or negative. So the predicted labels are in the rows. Okay. And the columns are the actual label of C of X is positive and the actual label of X is negative. So we have the columns giving just like a truth table 0001 1011, the same combination is being used, and look what are true positives. If the actual label is positive, that is C, and the predictor label is C, then we have true positive. If the actual label is not C and the predictor label is C, okay, so it is positive prediction, but it is actually negative. So it's a false positive. Okay, so if the actual label is positive C and the predicted label is not C, that means the prediction is negative, but it is false. So we have a false negative. If the actual label is also negative, is not C, and the predicted label is not C, that means it's correct. It is truly negative. So it is true negative. Okay, so this is our confusion matrix. Okay, so we are going to look at confusion matrix. If you look at, it's just the same thing that we have seen in the previous slide. A confusion matrix is a table that categorizes predictions according to whether they match the actual value. Okay, so based on the actual value and the predicted value, we are creating the table. Now there are, if it's a two class problem, then this is our confusion matrix. This is our confusion matrix. We have one true positive. Okay, one set of values which is true positive, that is when the actual condition and the predicted condition is true. And we have true negative, this is not Fn, this is Tn. We have true negative when the actual condition is false and the predicted condition is also false. So we have a true negative. The other two cases, Fp and Fn, are both errors. Okay, so if the prediction is true, but the actual condition is false, we have a false positive. And if the prediction is false, but the actual condition is true, we have a false negative. So I hope you have understood this. Now, just looking at an example, we have a multi-class data. This was for a two-class data set. Now we have a multi-class data set. If we have three classes, cat, dog, and rabbit, then we have actual cat, actual dog, actual rabbit, and predicted cat, predicted dog, predicted rabbit. And based on that, we will have the values. Okay, so here we have more than one true positive, all the diagonal values, this 5, 3, and 11 are all true positives, because predicted is cat and actual is cat. Here predicted is dog and actual is dog. Here predicted is rabbit and actual is rabbit. So true positive will be 5 plus 3 plus 11. Okay, and true negative will be when these two values, so for the case of cat, the true negative will be both the cases where the actual dog and the actual rabbit are negative in the case of cat. In the case of dog, the values which are not dog, that is cat and rabbit, will be true negatives for the case of dog. That is how we have to calculate for the case of multiple classes. Now, normally for our exams, we have two class problems, so it will not be as complicated as all that. So we can get into it. Okay. Now this is important. Precision and recall. Okay. Now the term precision. Precision means how correctly does the model, the classification algorithm or classification model, predict the true values. Okay, so the classification algorithm has predicted as true both true positives and false positives. Okay, so the algorithm has predicted as true both the true positives and the false positives. Out of all the cases where the classification algorithm has predicted as true, which are actually true? Okay, so the precision is true positive divided by both the true positive plus the false positive. Okay, so that is precision. How many of the predicted positive values are actually positive? That is precision. Now recall. When it is recalled, we have to recall not only the true positives, we also have to recall the true negatives. Okay. Or the false positives, we have to recall that also. Okay, so all the positive values, actual positive values, had to be recalled by the classification model after training. But maybe all of them are not being recalled. So we want to know, out of all the actual positive values, how many has been recalled by the classification algorithm. Okay, so from our confusion matrix, which are the actual positive values? The actual positive values are, of course, true positive, and those that were classified as negative, but they were not negative, that were also positive. So true positive and false negatives are actually positive. Okay, so out of all the positives, how many are truly positive is the recall. That is how much has been predicted as positive by the model. So that is the true positives. So true positive divided by true positive plus false negative is recall. Okay, so once you know this, the question problems that can come is a scenario will be given to you. You have to create the confusion matrix. After creating the confusion matrix, calculate the precision and the recall if that is what is being asked. There are other measures which we will be looking at later. Now we will just do a few problems on precision and recall. The first problem is, suppose a computer program for recognizing dogs. So what is positive? C is the concept of dog. So we are actually looking at whether a particular instance is a dog or is not a dog. Okay, whether it is a cat or a rabbit or whatever it is, we are not interested in that. All we are interested in is whether a particular instance can be correctly classified as a dog or a not dog, because it's only recognition for dogs. Okay, so suppose a computer program for recognizing dogs in photographs identifies 8 dogs in a picture. So the classification algorithm has looked at one picture, and from that picture it has identified 8 dogs, which actually contains 12 dogs and some cats. We don't know the number of cats. Okay, so there are actually 12 dogs. Out of the whole thing, there is dogs and cats, and the system has identified 8 dogs. It says that 8 are of those images dogs. But of these 8 dogs identified, only 5 are actually dogs. The rest were cats. Okay, so we need to compute the precision and the recall. Now we know that we need the confusion matrix values. So we are going to draw the confusion matrix first. So since dog is our parameter, our instance or unit of observation, we have got actual dog and actual not dog as the two cases in the column. And the system is predicting as dog or predicting as not dog. Okay, so from this description, we have that 8 images in the picture was identified as dogs. So TP plus FN, TP plus FP, okay, false positives and true positives together is 8. And it says over there that actually only 5 were dogs. So the true positives out of the 8 that is identified as dogs, only 5 are actually dogs. So true positive is 5. And out of the 8, 5 are actually dogs. That means the rest 3 are not dogs. So falsely positive classification is 3. Okay. Now, what was predicted as a not dog, but actually was a dog? That is, we know that if the information is given to us that 12 are actually dogs. So out of those 12, only 5 has been correctly classified. Okay, so 12 minus 5 is false negatives. Okay, so we have 7, which were actually dogs. Out of the 12, only 5 were correctly classified. So the rest of those 12 are not correctly classified. They were classified as not dogs. We don't know cats or whatever, just not dogs. Okay, and some which were not dogs were classified. So since the count of not dog or cats is not given to us, we cannot have a value for TN. So since it's not given, we are not finding the value there. But all we need for precision and recall are these 3 values, because precision is true positives out of all the positive classifications. So 5 out of 8 is precision. And recall was actually there were 12 dogs, but it was only able to classify 5 correctly. So 5 out of 12 is the recall. Okay, that's problem 1. Now let's look at another example, problem 2. Let there be 10 balls, and it's given that 6 are white and 4 are red, and they are all put in a box. and let it be required to pick up the red balls from them. So we are supposed to pick up all the red balls from them, not we, the machine. So the algorithm picked up 7 balls as red, of which only 2 are actually red. So out of the 10 balls, the algorithm has picked up 7 balls. And out of these 7 balls also, it did not pick up 2 which are actually red. Only 2 are actually red balls. The rest out of the 7 were not red balls. So now when we draw the confusion matrix, here also we are calculating precision and recall. So all we need is TP, FP and FN. Okay, so actual red, how many were predicted? Out of the predicted red, how many were actually red? Only 2. So true positives are 2. But out of the 7, 7 were predicted as red. So out of the 7, if 2 are actually correct, then 7 minus this actual red 2 is equal to the false positives. So 5 were wrongly classified as red. Okay, now out of the 4 balls which were actually red, only 2 were classified correctly. Okay, so that means the rest 2 was not classified correctly. So they are false. They're actually positive, but they are falsely predicted as not red. So they are false negative. 4 minus 2 is false negative. Okay, so the true negative, there was a mistake there. I've corrected it now. Out of the true negatives, see, when the system predicted not red, how many did it predict as not red? Out of the 10 balls, 7 were predicted as red. Only 3 were predicted as not red. Out of those 3, it says that 2 were actually red. Because 2 were not actually only out of the 7, only 2 were red. The others were not red. So that means out of those 3, there were 2 red. So how much is the truly negative? Out of the 3, 2 were actually red. So 3 minus 2, 1 is the true negative. So actually, true negative, actually, which was red, but predicted as also not, actually not red and predicted as not red was only 1. Okay, so if you want to know whether these are correct, see, we have 4 red balls, actually not red. There is a false positive plus the true negative must give me the red number of balls, and actually red must give me the red balls. Actually not red must give me the white balls. So 6 plus 1, 5 plus 1 is 6 and 2 plus 2 is 4. So that's how we know whether this is actually correct. Done. Okay, so now we have all the values that we need. All we need to do is substitute the values for precision and recall, and we get 2 out of 7 for precision and 1 out of 2 for recall. Okay, now the third problem is, assume the following. A database contains 80 records on a particular topic, of which only 55 are relevant to a certain investigation. So we don't know what the investigation is, but for a certain investigation, only 55 are actually relevant. A search was conducted on that particular topic, and the machine gave 50 records out of these 80 records. And of those 50 records, only 40 were actually relevant and 10 were not relevant. So true positive was 40. And out of that 50, 10 were not relevant. So that is false positives. Okay, now, out of this 80, if 55 are actually relevant, that means 25 are actually not relevant. Okay, so keeping that in mind, how many of the relevant are predicted as not relevant? 55 are actually relevant. Out of that, 40 was predicted as relevant. So the rest 15 are false negatives. Okay, and for true negatives, total number of negatives are 25, out of which 10 were falsely classified as positive. So actually classified as negative is 25 minus 10, 15. Okay, now we have all the values TP, FP, FN and TN. All we need to do is substitute the values in the formula and you get precision is 4 out of 5 and recall is 8 out of 11. Some of the other measures that we use for error, for finding error is, one is accuracy. This is important. This has been asked in previous question papers. Accuracy. Accuracy is not just the true positives. If the system is correctly classifying true negatives and true positives, that means those are both are correct classifications. Actual and the prediction are correct. So out of all the classifications, how many are true positive and true negative. So accuracy is true positive plus true negative divided by true positive plus true negative plus false negative. Okay. And error rate is 1 minus accuracy. Okay. So whatever is the accuracy, whatever is your accuracy rate, 1 minus that accuracy rate will give you your error rate. Okay. Now, sensitivity. Sensitivity is true positive divided by true positive plus false negative. This is the same as recall. Okay. Sensitivity is how well you can predict positive values. That is sensitivity. So it's the same as recall. Specificity is how well you can predict negative values. So it is the opposite of recall. It is true negative divided by true negative plus false positive. And F measure is a statistical measure which we use in many of the machine learning performance analysis, and that is given by 2 into true positive divided by 2 into true positive plus false positive plus false negative. Okay, now false positive and false negative both are error rates. Okay, so F measure is true positive divided by true positive, 2 into true positive plus false positive plus false negative. With this, we are ending today's class. This is an important topic you must learn. If you know how to correctly draw the confusion matrix, all the others, you can just learn the equation. You will be able to find the answers correctly. Hope you have understood this topic. Thank you.